very happy all of you are here. Of course, as always, it's quality as opposed to quantity that we're going for here. So again, thank you for being here this morning. So just a few words about our program this morning. It's said that when it comes to the arts, there are two judges. Two judges. Time and vox populi. Time and the voice, the opinions of people. And that very much may be true, but I would submit to you that they are unfair judges. Today we're going to hear, revisiting the music of Frescobaldi, and for reasons that I don't entirely understand, as you might be aware, Frescobaldi is not exactly a household name. If you don't know who Frescobaldi is, or I should say was, don't feel bad. Don't feel bad, you're in good company. Even people who claim to love classical music, whose whole life is classical music, they'll ask me, so, what are you playing in the recital tomorrow? And I'll say, well, I'm playing some music by Girolamo Frescobaldi. And they'll say, who? What? Is that some new composer? Yeah, right. Frescobaldi is not thought of in the same way as Bach or Mozart or Beethoven. And yet, I would also submit to you that without the music of Frescobaldi, the music of Bach, as we know it, is something entirely different. Frescobaldi is, in many ways, one of the most significant composers of the Renaissance and early Baroque eras, in as much as his music is formative. It lays the groundwork for composers such as Freiberger and Buxtehude and, yes, indeed, Bach. Just to refresh our memories, Frescobaldi was born in 1583 and lived until 1643. To put that in context, J.S. Bach was born in 1685 and lived until 1750, so a good generation before Bach, at the very least. Was born and spent most of his life in Italy, in his daily anyway, the Duchy of Ferrara. Which eventually became a papal duchy later on. Frescobaldi's output is mostly in the form of instrumental music, particularly music for keyboard instruments, organ and harpsichord at the time. One of his most famous collections and most pivotal collections is something called Fiori Musicali, Musical Flowers. It contains three organ masses, music that was to be played either really by itself as devotional music, or else in alternatum when singing the mass. You have a mass part, and then the organist would answer with the appropriate components. He wrote three of those. This is the second one, or at least excerpts of the second one here today. It is the music for the Mass for the feasts of the Apostles. So in other words, we'd have a feast, an apostolic feast in the church calendar. This is the music they would use. After I play the first piece, I'm going to play the chant very quickly, the chant upon which most of this music is based. You may or may not be able to pick that out. If you're into such things, you might even recognize this chant. It's one of the more well-known chants that's come down to us. And then at the very end, in good Renaissance and Baroque tradition, I'm going to do a brief improvisation on that chant, which was something they would have done at the time. So in other words, you'll hear Frescobaldi's written music, which are in many ways written out improvisations, and then at the very end you will hear a live, shall we say, improvisation, which probably won't be in the style of Frescobaldi, but I'll try to keep it out of the 20th century or 21st century as much as I can, just so your ears aren't shocked by that all of a sudden. No promises there, it is an improvisation, it's not all written down. I don't entirely know what it's going to be yet. If you have any questions about this music or the organ, or anything related. I'll take those questions afterwards, presuming you're all still here. Well, I have to say that because for a lot of folks, this music is so far removed from what people commonly listen today in their cars on the way to work, or in the shower, or while they're cooking their dinner. It, for a lot of folks, it almost doesn't register as music. So I kind of have to warn them. So I have had people come to me after recitals and say, "Well, I think you played pretty good, but that was the strangest sounding stuff I ever heard in my life." So be warned, and hopefully that shall be the reaction.